person from government offices? Any private sector here? Okay. So we're all Filipinos and we have Kawar, who's from India. So sayang, ngayon Tagalog. But I will shift from Filipino to English. But I'll try to speak in English as much as possible. My presentation of the session that was assigned to me is on the APEC project preparation and approval. And I have three parts in this particular session. First part will be the APEC overview and the context of Philippine participation. Second part will be the meat of the sandwich, which is on the project approval process and the quality criteria used to assess APEC projects. And this would cover the application for funding and also the project proposals and the budget. And the last part of the sandwich, the bread, would be the Philippine domestic process on developing projects, how you get it submitted eventually to APEC, and how hopefully we can guide you on accessing the funds and some tips on preparing a quality proposal. So the first part would be just to make sure that we're all on the same page, is a quick overview on the APEC. I think most of you are very familiar already. I see Nova is here. She's one of our partners in one of our projects that was held this year. So I have someone to call mommy, for example. But here in this slide, you see very self-explanatory what APEC is. It's a non-binding cooperation forum. We were one of the original members of APEC. Its headquarters is in Singapore, so that means the secretariat operates there. Secretariat is made up of different nationalities seconded from their governments from the 21 economies, including one from the Philippines, from the Foreign Affairs Ministry. And I think some of you are familiar with the objectives of APEC, which is to facilitate economic growth and prosperity through the three pillars, TILF, or trade and investment, liberalization and facilitation, and ECOTEC, which is economic and technical cooperation. The ECOTEC part is very important because this will make sure that the TILF will go as planned. Okay? And I think some of you are also familiar with what they always call the Bogor goals of 2010 and 2020. So this is like the main objective, or at least the mantra of APEC, to achieve free and open trade by 2010 for the developed economies and 2020 for the developing economies. So APEC is quite an important forum because it covers 39% of world population, 47% of world trade, and 60% of world GDP. So in this slide, you'll see the Philippines being an original member in 1989. Members are called member economies. So Taiwan is not called Taiwan, but she is called Chinese Taipei. And she represents Taiwan as a member economy because China, of course, would not agree to call her a state. So yun yung mga, some of the quirkiness of the APEC fund. So this one, Bogor Goals, I talked about this. This was the goal adopted by leaders in 1994 in Bogor, Indonesia. And this is still the main mantra of APEC. There have been many other initiatives, like you will hear about the services framework, you will hear about the supply chain framework, action plan, and all. But it's still really the Bogor Goals, which is the main goal of APEC, and that will expire soon in 2020. Right now, we're discussing a post-Bogor or post-2020 vision. This is how the organization works. At the highest level, would be the leaders' meeting. And just recently, we had the APEC summit in Port Moresby. I think some of you were made aware of some news coming from there, including the attendance of our president, he stayed on just to clarify. Hindi po siya umuwi na maaga. He was there. In fact, nauna pa po ako umuwi sa kanya. Except he didn't cover all of the meetings. I think because he was tired, just coming from Singapore. And he was represented during the last session, the working lunch, by Secretary Lopez. But he was able to attend the most important sessions, including the dialogue with business. So they're at the highest level. That's at the policy level. And together with the ministers, in the blue boxes, that constitutes the policy structure of APEC. And then at the working level would be the green ones. So at the blue, there's the ministerial level. So there is the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and Trade attending jointly in the lead up to the leaders meeting. And then throughout the year, there would be some sectoral ministerial meetings, including the finance ministers meeting, trade ministers, SME ministers, or depending on the priorities of the host, there would sometimes be a mining minister's office and so on. And they are assisted by the senior officials. Our senior official is from Foreign Affairs. Right now it's ASEC Leo Herrera-Lim. And he's supported by the DFA National Secretariat and the DTI, who is the deputy senior official. At the green, this is the working level. So you will see the different committees. The major committees would be the Committee on Trade and Investment. And then there is the Budget and Management Committee. Ito yung mga money issues and all. And then there's Economic Committee, which is actually broader than the CTI issues or Committee on Trade and Investment. And then the SOM Level Steering Committee on Economic and Technical Cooperation. So over the years, the APEC structure has grown. Then you'll see napaka marami ng mga, there's a lot of branches already. And one of the bigger committees would be the SOM Steering Committee on Ecotec, because it has a lot of sectoral issues. And also the Committee on Trade and Investment, because there are so many issues that could be related to trade. We will go back to this one later when I show you which are the agencies representing us. This slide will show you the different themes and priorities that have evolved from 2014 to present. And I think I need to mention that we always try to have continuity, at least among the chairs or the hosting economies. They try to keep the continuity in the APEC goals. And in the past few years, the theme that has been coming up would be on promoting regional economic integration, that's always there, and connectivity, and then maybe, especially since our hosting year, inclusivity throughout the region. So you will see during China's hosting year in 2014, one of the key priorities was to strengthen connectivity and infrastructure development. And then in our year, we brought in the MISMI, or the micro and SME issues. MSMEs have always been an agenda in APEC, but it was never at the level of leaders, nor the trade and foreign affairs ministers. It's always at the working group level. So it was in our year where we really pressed and brought the MISMI issue at the front and center of APEC. And I think this is where it should stay, front and center. I mean, we should think small first. Then also we will see the cross-cutting themes of trade and investment. So that's why there's always the REI, or Regional Economic Integration Agenda, which is also which also supports the continuity theme of any host here. Connectivity is also one of the highlighted priorities for PNG's hosting this year, which ended actually last week. By the way, we don't have a chair statement yet or a ministerial declaration. It's the first time in the history of APEC that has happened. And hindi ko na alam. I don't know what I will tell you in terms of developing projects because we don't have a ministerial leader statement. But we will try to come up with something for you. What is the Philippines' interest in APEC? Since I'm from trade, of course, I will always say it's the trade and investment part. This is a forum for us to promote our trade in goods, service, investment, transfer of technology, and professional skills. And we also use APEC to push the programs or at least confirm the appropriateness of the policy tracks that we have taken in the government. We use it to engage agencies to undertake reforms. We use it to advocate for more open economies. And also to just show you how important APEC is as a forum, this pie chart will show you how big the APEC market is in terms of trade. 80, even my slide here is very malabo, but you see 83, I think that's 83% of our export goes to APEC economies. And the top economies for our exports will be Japan, the USA, Hong Kong, China, Singapore, and others. So that's really a big part of our trade. And then in terms of imports, it's also the same. We get a lot of our imports from other APEC economies. So that's why we always, beyond the ministerial declaration and the ministerial statements and the different press releases, we are not even sure if people read them. It's really this one that's very important to us, that we are able to get engaged with our major trading partners. And in terms of investments also, I cannot overstate how important the APEC region is. So you'll see from here who are the main investing countries. All of them are APEC economies. And then the sectors where their investments go. So in the past year, it was in manufacturing, in real estate, administrative and support activities, electricity and other services, and information and communication. Also, you see a lot of it would really go to the services sector. Malaki lang yun sa manufacturing, pero the rest are on the services sector. So part two now, I will move to the presentation from the APEC Secretariat. Okay. I'm doing this because I don't want you to miss the important parts. We are not really experts at my bureau on developing proposals, but we were fortunate enough to have had projects funded by APEC. We were also able to assist some agencies to come up with proposals and get APEC funding. And also last March, we were able to attend a training conducted by the APEC Project Management Unit. I think personally that this is the information that you need to use. And so we didn't change anything from the slides that were shared to us by the APEC Project Management Unit. Okay. So this presentation will cover a short introduction to the APEC projects, why is it important to APEC, the funding information, what are the available funding options you can tap, the concept note approval process, what you have to go through to have a proposal approved, some tips on preparing that concept note, which the APEC Secretariat has shared some tips in this particular presentation, and also the forms and the resources to use. It's very pretty straightforward. The first part of the APEC project approval process is really the concept. But before I go to that, this is just to emphasize that, as I mentioned, Ecotech is the third pillar of APEC, if you remember. And this is really to focus on the capacity building and information sharing, which is to advance the goals of trade and investment, liberalization and facilitation. And for APEC, what better way to do that but to promote capacity building among economies through the projects. So projects are process. And through capacity building, they are able to, APEC is able to translate the goals into reality. And the APEC projects are not limited to workshops and trainings, although they are very important, but they can also take other forms, including researches, websites, and guidebooks. A quick overview on a APEC project history. We have, APEC has implemented more than 2,200 projects since 1993, and on average it approves 80 to 100 projects per year. The average value of APEC projects funded over time is $130,000. And a standard APEC project must be completed within 2 financial years. So there are 2 funding sessions every year. The APEC Budget and Management Committee, if you remember from the structure that I showed you, one of the green boxes, this is the committee which is responsible for setting the policies and for approving the projects. So that's a very important committee. We are represented in that committee by the Department of Foreign Affairs. Like I mentioned earlier, APEC projects may come in several forms. So we have the usual workshops, training seminars, and symposiums. You may also conduct research projects, publications, websites, and databases. On this one, the funding is limited to design and development, and management and maintenance is not covered. These are the sources of funding for APEC projects. First is the general project account. This is for any general project. Second, there's the trade and investment liberalization and facilitation special account. So just from the name, you will know already what is the focus of this particular fund. And then there's the APEC support fund. So the APEC support fund is for projects which support the capacity building needs for developing economies only. The other funds like the GPA and the TILF, developed economies can access that. So mostly we put our proposals under the ASF. But the ASF has both the general fund and the sub funds. Some of the sub funds have eligibility criteria, so there are very strict criteria. For example, the Miss Me sub fund, they have to make sure that the end beneficiary, of course, would be the Miss Me, the migrant SMEs. And then it doesn't stop there. There are some particular areas which have to be covered, like, for example, capacity building, improving exports. Or women entrepreneurs and all. So some very clear criteria. We can provide this to you once you already identify what particular sub-fund you will use. Okay, so this one shows the funds available for 2018, and that was back in March 2018. We don't have information yet on the funds available for 2019, but we can ask our DFA colleagues as the representative to the BMC provide us any figures. So from the 2018 fund figures, you will note that it's the GPA, the APEC Support General Fund, and the APEC ASF sub-fund on energy and RACER. RACER stands for Renewed Action Agenda on Structural Reform. So just think structural reform, SR. These have the largest shares of contributions. Whereas the sub-fund on women, Miss Miss, and innovative development and economic reform and growth have the least amount of share. Some of them, I'll just to share, some economies have sub-funds associated to them. For example, the Miss Me sub-fund is associated to Canada because they were the ones who established this sub-fund. The Women's sub-fund is associated to the United States. Okay. So each have means you might be competing for very limited funds, and also you have to make sure that you're able to satisfy all the criteria for the particular sub-fund that you're targeting. So this just to show how much project applications are received versus the project approval. So medyo malaki yung difference. Who can apply for APEC funds? Any economy. And this has to be done through an APEC forum. The proposing economy leads the design and the delivery of the project through the project overseer or PO. And the application can be made anytime, but the assessment is done only 2 times a year. So you'll see here again the reference to the concept note, which is 3 pages. This year, this is the concept note stage and project proposal stage. So next year, we might anticipate the same schedule. March for the first deadline to submit a concept note. And then the decision will come out in May. And then for the second funding session, June, and the decision to come out in August. So if you have something already in mind, let us know so we can prepare for the March funding session. Some introduction on the acronyms. The POs would be project overseers, so he's responsible overall for the submission of documents and the implementation of the project if it is approved. Program director is your main liaison at the APEC Secretariat. He's actually the APEC Secretariat, and he's very, the PD is very important because he will give you tips, they will tell you the deadlines, they will tell you if your project is approved or not. And then the program executives are the assistants of the program directors. The project management unit is the committee that runs the selection quality assessment process. They do the approval basically. So this is the process for getting approval for a concept note. Stage one is, of course, the concept note. And what is in there? Firstly, it has an overview of the project, 3 pages, all 3 pages, which covers the overview of the project, what is its relevance to the APEC agenda, 3 pages endorsed by what particular fora. So if you recall the structure that I showed you, so any one of the sanga-sanga, the branches there, could be the fora. And then you have to indicate there when you submit a concept note what fora it is. And as I said, only the concept notes of proof of funding will go towards to the second step. The concept note is the most critical stage. I mean, hindi ka na makakalayo kapag hindi ka pumasa dito. Okay? So you have to come up with something that is very clear already. Sometimes, you just say it's concept note, but really you already have it in mind what you want, the goal that you want. I mean, is it going to be a workshop? Is it going to be a research publication with a workshop? Is it going to be a website, and also klaro na yon. Begin with the end in mind. That's what I will always say. And then you just work out the details. We will help you on that. Okay. So there's the things that you need to remember: the internal submission deadline. So I already showed you yung mga initial deadlines from this year. You have to work closely with the agency that you will work with in order to come up with your proposal. Unfortunately, I think not all of you are members of the subfora and the committees, diba? Because some of you are from the university. So you need to work with the government agency. So I'll show you later who the agencies you should work with. So for the internal submission deadline, at this time, the project overseer, you, should have been able to socialize your proposal well, not just with the agency in the Philippines, but also with the other economies. So your agency part And then this goes up at many levels, at the subcommittee level, at the committee, all the way up to senior officials, even up to ministers sometimes. Like if there's a project that you're really keen to work on, you have to tell us. It has to come all the way to the DFA so we can sell the project. Because the approval is really, it will come from the members here. Even if you have the perfect proposal, if it's not sold well, unfortunately, it will not be approved. Okay? You have to get the buy-in of the economies. Okay? And so that's for the internal submission deadline. The final submission deadline, ito, we're just talking about the consent note pa lang, wala pa tayo sa approval. So after the concept notes are submitted, you made it to the deadline, these concept notes are ranked by the APEC forum, who's responsible for the funding. For example, you put SME working group for the sub forum. That SME working group will now rank your proposals, and there will be many other project concept notes received. So hopefully, you will get first ranking one. Because if you're ranking one, that's just the first step at the SME working group. Because there's another step. This is for all the projects now, including other fora and committees. So you have to aim for the highest rankings, first and second. Higher rank concept notes get the funding. Kasi like, if you remember from the figures of available funds, kunwari, 800,000 dollars left in the missing fund. But there were like 7 who submitted all at 150,000 or 100,000. That means only 5 or 4 or 3 will be funded. So you have to get really the high ranking. Okay. So you need to sell the proposal. When economists know about it more, if they say that they will support it, then it's more likely to be ranked. So these are the steps: internal submission, the final submission, the scoring, and then the secretariat, based on the scoring, will now recommend to the budget and management committee which concept notes can be funded. And these are based on the order of the scores. Once they are, if they make it through to the funding cutoff, they are considered approved in principle. And they will now go into the second part of the process. The second process. This is now the project preparation. Okay. But before we go to that, some tips. First, you have to review all the information on the project's pages. That's in the website of APEC. Please note it down. Make sure you're using the correct concept note template. They just change again the template, or there might be another one. They always change it every year. So you can get it from the APEC website. Also look at the scoring template when preparing your concept note. So we'll see this in the coming slide. After the internal submission deadline, the proposing firm is only required to endorse concept notes. They will no longer be scored. Okay, so I don't know when the score will come. After the final submission, they have to be endorsed. So even if you're able to submit it already within the deadline, they need to be endorsed. And sometimes, although I don't think it has ever happened to the Philippines, one economy would say, we don't like that project. Usually this happens between China and the US. They have some thing between them that they're always tell each other, okay, I want out. If someone wants out from your proposal, that's a big problem for us, the agencies. You have to convince them. That means you have to go back to the drawing board and make some revisions. Yeah. But it has never happened to us. Wala pa po kaming na-encounter na ganun sa mga proposals ng Philippines. Mostly, they're just quiet, but those who would support us would just really support us all the way. Occasionally, we would get comments like they would want maybe some of their ideas to be put in, for example, maybe on a project on women, they would want one of their speakers to come from their economy and they have a an idea that they want to be sold. For example, they want green circular economy. So they would want to find a way to put that in the concept note already. So yeah, we can live with those comments. Madali lang po yun. That's easier. The hard part is when they say that they cannot support the project. So parang mo nalang sinabing that's not what na. But not to discourage you, it never happens to us. Okay. So other tips by the secretariat. Okay, we'll look at the template siguro para you can understand this. Okay. So this is, well, this is the new model that's being trialed now. Apparently, we are na, the scoring now ends only at the different fora. So hindi na siya after the scoring at the fora level, hindi na siya dadalhin sa mas mataas. So for each fund, pag mauubos na, and your project comes low in the ranking, though, okay, that's it, that's the end. There's no more scoring, ito na lang talaga. You just really have to sell it to the fora you're preparing, you have indicated in your concept note. So this matrix shows you who will be scoring your concept note. So if you have an energy project, that will go to the energy working group. If it's health, it's to the subcommittee on Ecotech. If it's mining, it goes to the mining task force. If it's trade and investment, it goes to CTI. So that will be us at DTI. And you can always count on us. To be honest, we're not neutral when we do the scoring. Pag Philippines yung nag-propose, we always put it number one. Then, sa totoo lang po, bakit ko naman bibigyan naman taas na score niya iba, diba? And if we, because we always want agencies to be engaged, di ba? And this is our way to get back all the money that we spend traveling to these countries. And also because we have what we call the International Commitment Fund. We pay a lot just to be a member of APEC. So we want it back. So for sure, number one na kayo. But to be able to be number one also, we work closely with you. Para may you have quality concept notes. Ayaw din namin ng mga pahiya, of course. And we want to make sure that this project is really relevant. Will benefit not just you, but also us. And of course, the Filipino people. It's very important. Okay. So for the CTI, for example, there are different sub-funds that we cover. First, the TILF, so Trade and Investment Liberalization Facilitation. This is a fund started by Japan, but their contributions have petered down, so now it's just like general. All economies now contribute to that. There is also the Supply Chain Connectivity Sub-Fund, which was started by, I think it was started by Singapore, and during their hosting year, and then when the funds ran out, there were contributions that came in from Hong Kong and then from other economies. There is a sub-fund under the Supply Chain Connectivity Sub-Fund, which is contributed to by the U.S., and I think it's mostly related to the implementation of the Trade Facilitation Agreement. So we would be in charge of that one. And then there's also another supply chain connectivity sub-fund related project. Well, it's not supply chain, it's GVC, Global Value Chain. The sub-fund on FTAC Free Trade Area of the Asia-Pacific and the GVC sub-fund, which is run by China. Okay, when I say runs, because they put in the first deposit, but the eligibility criteria is decided by the entire CTI body. So this one's very specific. For example, FTAP, it will be improving the quality of our free trade agreements, working towards creating an eventual free trade area of the Asia Pacific. So yeah, we will hope. It would have been useful sana if I had the figures now, how much has been used up from this year and then going to the next year. Unfortunately, we don't have that because we don't attend the BMC. but we can get it from the DFA. So ito, this is the scoring template. So you will already know how your concept note will be assessed. So there is a score, yan yung over 20, over 15. So for each criteria, yun yung points. And the total is 60. So just looking at the scoring criteria. First, una, yes or no, is this concept note eligible for funding? For example, di pala siya, mismi siya, nilagay niyo siya sa FTAP fund. Wala na yun, X na kaagad. So it's really important that you know where your concept note, which fund you will tap. Okay? So, and then there's the real criteria, the five criteria. First, should support the priorities of the APEC fund to which you're applying to. Second is the quality. Is it strong? Second, does it support my economy's priorities? Yes or no, score of 10, support capacity building, support cross-foreign collaboration and benefits to multiple economies. We do the ranking for all the CTI sub-fund or fund, and we also use this tool to make sure that you get yung higher ranking. Like for example, I would see there was a Philippine project and a Vietnam project. Of course, I will rank the Vietnam project lower. Numerical siya parang ganun. So, talagang, kunwari, hindi siya science-based kasi, ano na, opinion ko na lang yun, di ba? How would I know if you support your economy's priorities? Di ba, hindi ko nga alam kung ano yung priority ng Vietnam. But I do know the Philippine priority. So, I'm able to give it a higher ranking. Diba? And, cross-foreign collaboration, that's important. Maganda, if your work is not only for trade, but that it also involves working with other agencies and other fora. For example, your trade facilitation, not just ETI, but working with the Bureau of Customs, maybe, or maybe working with NEDAD, on the Economic Committee, and working with other agencies, for the Department of Health, and for FDA, for some trade facilitation initiative. That's important. Okay, next. So ito, I hope you will look closely at this para while you're developing your content note, you can already tailor fit it. Okay, so these are the specific guidelines for us as a scorer. So look at it very carefully. Yung quality of the proposal, so you will already see yung ano yung mga ginagamit nilang measures. Relevance, impact, effectiveness, sustainability, efficiency. Yun. So yun yung mga things that you have to work on in your concept note. You have to be able to show all of these traits in your concept note. Next, key advice from the secretariat, always make it to the deadline. There is no postponement. When they say 28 April, that's it. Maximum 3 pages. Be clear on your funding source. Address the eligibility criteria if there is a criteria in the fund that you've identified. Capacity building is central to all projects, but you must show how your project will support capacity building needs for APEC developing economies. So for example, your proposal should not just benefit the Philippines, it should have a regional or at least all the other developing economies. Write clearly and succinctly for an audience, non-experts. Okay, so kung may mga acronyms kayo, spell it out. Do not be too academic. Kunwari, you're just talking to the layman. Kasi yung some topics may be very technical, di ba? But the PMU, the people there are not experts. And then so on, secure at least two co-sponsoring economies. So it's always, there's always a part there in the template, concept note template that says supporting economies. Minimum of two. So, eto, we have to work closely with the agencies to make sure that they are able to get the buy-in of two other economies. We don't normally have a hard time doing this. In fact, there's a lot of the developing economies are easy to talk to, like Peru, yung katabi namin in the table. You can always, oh, please support our project. And they said, they have their project, oh, please support us. So yung tip for that. Yeah. But the more project supporters you have, the better. Kasi when they do the ranking, tas lumabas talaga, ay, when, they do the assessment and ranking. And the ranker sees na, ay, ang dami ng support. He may tendency siya talaga to give a higher rating. Higher score. Okay. Project end date is always December of the following year. Give enough time for you. Kasi pag hindi, you have to renew po. Babalik kayo ulit, you have to get approval again. Para, well, not approval for the start of the project, pero parang it's another paperwork. So, just make sure na at least 2 years na yung effectivity ng project concept note. And then, of course, use the most recent template. It's in the APEC website. Okay, self-funded project. Ito yung mga hindi na fund. So this is the self-funding track. Anytime you want to put forward a project, you can do that. It has to be approved though by the group. It should also comply with the guidelines of APEC. So, for example, Ateneo wants suddenly to have their own, they want to call it an APEC project or publication, they still have to go to APEC so they can get the seal niya and all. It has to be endorsed by all economies. Some of the countries who do this are Russia, because sometimes you have mga ideas nila is too ahead of APEC, so they would just come out with some studies. But before they can even do that, it has to be endorsed by all. So, minsan ready na sila sa publication nila, but hindi pa rin sila pinapalusot ng ibang bansa eh. So, unfortunately, sorry, it will not get the APEC branding. Okay. The other economies who are also very good or who always use this track would be the US, because some of their projects also, like Russia, are sometimes ahead of us. Like when years ago, when they wanted to work on digital trade and they couldn't get approval from China, they would just do it self-funded. Okay, so look at also when your project is approved and all, the overseer has to, there's a lot of admin stuff in there, including the completion report. This goes also for self-funded projects. So this is how the concept note looks like. So maximum yan ng 3 pages if you fill in the blanks. Then there's the budget part here. You see, and ito, you have to be exact dun sa budget. Pasobrahan nyo na lang, don't make it less. Kasi mahirap humingi ng additional fund. Okay? Mas madaling magbalik ng pera, di ba? Kasi humingi. So, always put an extra or contingency fund. And there are, in the project guidebook, there are allowable funds. For example, if you're putting in, giving honoraria, I think the maximum that you can give is $1,500 a day, no more than that. It sounds pero alam mo yung ibang speakers para sa kanila pa ba naman parang but 1.5 you have to be able to justify why you're giving 1.5 is the maximum ha? You have to be able to justify why you're giving 1,500. That means your speaker is probably Elon Musk or Jack Ma. Di naman. Some people yung talagang, siguro maraming PhD, tugtog na yung name sila. So they really approve for this kind. Because sometimes the secretariat will really ask, we think it's not justified, you will give this amount. Yeah. Oh, but we were able to do that. I think we were able to do that for a foreign speaker in one of our projects in 2015. Si Bernard Hochman. Because Bernard Hochman is so well known in the trade circle. It's like, I think, author of so many books. Yeah. We use that to really bring them over. Because it's a parang that's a lot of effort for them. Eh. But we just tell them, this is for the Philippines. We will give you an honorary. Some of them, actually, they told it honorary pro bono. Yeah. We got some very good speakers before in Western State Dispute Settlement Project namin. From Hong Kong University, from ICG, International Court of Justice, no honorario. They just really wanted to do it. So, paiba-iba din. They keep lahin din. And then, if once you get through the concept note stage na, tapos approve na kayo yung principle, dapat maaga pa lang kinukuha na ano, sinsulat niya na kasi yung mga speakers niyo. Para, you know, madali din kasi mag-negotiate if you prepare. But then, we'll go to that mamaya. Okay. How do we convince? Ito, it goes into the concept note. I mean, it's not just selling it to the APEC economies, but, and the only way they can do that is through the concept note, diba? So, ito yun. You have to convince them that the project is really relevant and very much aligned to the APEC goals, and that it will benefit not just the Philippines, but the entire region. Describe the problem or opportunity addressed by this project. Okay. And then, ito yun, how does it, again, on relevance question one, first it has to be linked to specific APEC priority goals, and we can see that in the statements, ministerial statements, declarations, APEC strategies, and the APEC initiatives. Sometimes you need to have also a good hand on what's happening in APEC in order to come up with a relevant project. Kasi might be relevant, pero baka relevant siya 2 years ago, di ba? Maganda yung forward thinking kayo. One of the economies who has done this, yung magaling sila, would be Vietnam. Parang always ano sila, ready sila for a project. I think meron silang katalog na ng nagawa na nila, and then they just pull out, parang, there's the, in the ministerial declaration, there was a reference to waste management. So may ready na sila, tapos sasabit na nila ganun. They're so ano talaga, parang ready. I hope we can do that also. Like, we would have a database of all concept notes, and then we will just pull it out, call you, whoever developed that concept note, and they'll tell you, oh, are you still ready to do this project on circular economy? Because now's the right time because we have it in the statement. Can we put it ahead? Tapos sasabihan nyo kami, yes, ready po. Then we go and get funding for that. We hope we can get that, di ba? Adikta, parang, ang tawag
niyo. Hopefully, we can.
Okay, yeah. So we have that, parang anytime pwede kami mag-pull kung ano na. Timing din kasi, it's very important. Objectives. Ito yung objectives ng project. As I mentioned, has to be your concept room has to be clear on objectives. It's still SMART. I think you're all familiar with that already. Okay. Mahirap kasi kapag alam nyo na ang APEC, it's really a talk shop. Anything goes. But then you have to be very clear on the when you're sa project. I mean, you cannot say you want to work on poverty alleviation. It's hard, di ba? Parang how do you measure that? How can you even obtain that in one project? Yun. So you have to be very clear. Okay. And so it's as important that you connect your project should be connected to previous or planned projects. And in work plans, there are no work plans in APEC. It's really statements by the leaders and ministers. Some committees, they do have their work plans, but you have to have the intimate knowledge of that, and that you can find out through the different agencies. Okay. So how do you turn your idea into an actual project? Okay, overall, be concise, including only essential details. Yung mga ibang ingredients na rito, palabok and all, that will come when you do the project proposal. Concept note pa lang tayo. In your concept note, you have to put these details. What? Workshop, for example, or when, within this time, where, if it's a workshop, where will it be held, how will you do it? By conducting the workshop or by coming up with a publication. Yeah. So it's important to indicate outputs for each step. Yeah. So I feel that this group would be more of research projects, diba? That's pretty clear naman. But do not, parang do not close the door. It could be a research project title workshop. Ang ganda din yun, diba? Kung magkakasya sa 130,000. Why not, diba? Okay. Ito din, on the methodology. Who are the beneficiaries? So focus on the direct beneficiaries. Who will directly use these outputs? Yeah. Evaluation, again, it's the smart evaluation indicators. If you have baseline indicators at the start, at or before the start of the project, that is also important to put in your concept note. Longer-term evaluation is important to APEC and alert participants to expect further evaluation service from the secretariat. This normally applies to workshops and trainings. Then linkages, is this a follow-up? Is it new? Are you picking up from an old study? Is it exploratory, something new? What have you done domestically? What has APEC done? What are other like OECD, UN, UNCTAD, WTO doing? Put that in your project. Are you going to do this? Your agency will advise you if you can do it, how you can emphasize the collaboration. I think we do not expect from this group for you to know better. But you can already point out, like for example, it's an energy project that might be related to regulatory clearance, for example. Okay, then we might do it with DOE and NEDA. Avoid duplication and leverage otherwise. So let us know as early as you have something in mind so we can tell you. Usually we advise them, Korea just did this project on ganito, maybe you want to pick up from that. We always give those tips. And then for the budget, use a template to calculate your concept note, be accurate. And realistic, of course, not just accurate, but realistic. I mean, baka naman, because I said meron mga, may mga ranges eh. For example, workshop, I think maximum yata ng 10,000. I'm not sure, okay? Not very sure, parang $10,000 yata or less a day. Basta meron for it. Oh, it's $3,000 a day for venue. Because APEC does not fund meals. Even so, we try to go around that particular guideline. Ginagawa namin, we just talk to the hotel and tell them, can you just reflect in your in the contract that we're just paying for the venue but not the meals. Okay, so there are some ways to go around which are still legal, because internal arrangement yon, we have a separate contract talaga, pero at the same time it's just that APEC has this weird rule na parang they will not fund for the meals. Alam naman ng mga naman nila, di ba? The venue comes with meals, di ba? So, hindi ko alam kung bakit sila ganun. But there are ways to do that. And the maximum a day is, I think, $3,000. So, that's 150,000 pesos. Okay na yun, di ba? That's for 80 packs. Okay na yun. Yeah. So, may maximum. If you put 20,000, hindi na yun, trust that the APEC will already say that's too much. And then they also have, some comments, and they would say, but this is a 5-star hotel. We don't normally allow parang ganun. So we just choose usually a 4-star hotel. At saka sino iba yung papasok sa 150,000 kung lang yun talaga. Yeah. I think they need to update that. Okay. So we'll help you do the research, of course, but if you have something in mind, we'll tell you kung if there have been other projects done already. And there is also the please check it out so you see the range of projects that have been done. There's been a lot, okay, including on research proposal. So ito yun, this is how it looks like. You just type in yung topic and kung anong years yung gusto. Siguro maybe in the recent 5 years, yun yung mga maganda tignan. And then, which countries did that? That's important, that information will help us try to find you the co-sponsors. Kung alam natin that Korea works on authorized economic operators, yun yung mga gusto ng projects, then for sure, Korea, we will reach out to Korea to be our one of our co-sponsors. Or in your own work, siguro, like for example, you have your own network, and you know that there is a particular group, for example, you've been working with the U.S. on this particular topic, we will use that information so we can also reach out to them. Just tell them. Our colleagues have been working on you on this particular project in maybe in another setting, like in UN or some, or in another organization, that will help us sell the idea to them so they will sign on to us. Then overall style, be clear, be specific. Use standard non-technical language. I think you've said this already. And then this one, ito, for us to do, for, together with the agencies, engage with your economist representative. Okay. You have to really work with us. You have to work with the agencies. Unless, I don't know kung sa, APEC sa December number to the approved projects. Parang di ba, no? Yeah, you really have to work with the agencies. So, we will do everything so we can support your project. I think the DBAM, the Technical Board on APEC Matters, is chaired by the DFA. One of their objectives is to get as many proposals for the Philippines. Okay, so you will help us come up with these proposals. And then the guidelines and ulit-ulit lang talaga. Ito, check the latest version of the concept note, template, and then the development materials and the guide on APEC. Just a little too much for you at this stage, but siguro yung muna niyang titignan ko the template. Yeah. And the guide book later on, we walk you through that pag you're ready na with the concept note. I mean, no use studying this kapag you can even go over yung first stage, which is the concept note. So there are so many forms. We'll walk you through that once you just overcome yun ang kung concept note and project proposal stage. Okay? Yeah. Siguro we can break. Do you want to? Or maybe I can ask for questions now before I go to the second part of my presentation.
Maximum breadth.
For any project, but $200,000 and above, that has to be open to all. Mag-request na for a proposal, RFO, RFP, it will be open to anyone. So normally we advise agencies or our partners, knowledge partners, to have a proposal which is below that, para hindi na kailangan i-open. Kumbaga, yung bidding close na tayong dalawa na lang. We have someone in mind. We have a consultant in mind now. So we did that in one of our project and energy services. We made sure that, I'm not sure if I'm saying giving the right na ano, amount. Okay, dito na lang. There's no limit, but you have to justify, if it's a multi-year project, syempre mas malaki yung amount. Generally, 130,000 is the average range of a project. Okay, I have to go back. On the consultancy, there's a fee for consultancy. If it's $20 and above, we have to open that. Kahit na sinong bansa ka lang.
For
bidding.
For bidding?
Oo. Okay, pwedeng mag-bid kahit sino. If it's $20,000 and less, like $19,990, pwedeng directed yun. We can already justify, kunwari, Filipino na consultant, we can put it there. We can just submit to them, this is the consultant we have. We think they are appropriate because of this. Then consultancy team who are the, who's the head of all the ano. I'm sure you have that in mind.
Maximum amount of grant is $200,000.
No, no, no. Don't put it there. I think maximum. Walang maximum.
There's no maximum.
There's no maximum.
Aim for something lower than $200,000.
Yeah, yung generally is 130,000. Yun yung average na approved na ito.
It would go for how many months? Or 1 year?
1 year, implementation is 2 years. Yeah. Yung, I think ang relevant sa inyo will be the consultancy ano, fee, no? So yung 20,000, yun yung i-open nila. Pag below that, okay na.
When you say bidding, ano yung bid sa mga economies?
Ipopost yun sa website ng APEC.
And it's your idea, like the concept note, if you have an idea for a concept note, which is more than $200,000, then they will bid it out.
Because the 200,000, you have to break it down. Because I don't think APEC has ever given, parang, yung 200,000 kasi covers labor, travel, venue, honorarium, and all. So you have to break it down. Now, in the consultancy fee, where your project would fall, di ba? Most of your projects would fall, ang ipipit out is that portion lang. The 200,000, the rest, like for example, travel and all, actually, you're not going to see that eh. Ang mag-a-administer nun is APEC Secretary.
Capital outlay or?
No, no.
No capital outlay?
No, you mean capital equipment? Like, do they pay for that? No.
Ano lang ang coverage niya?
Services.
Services
na. Yeah, the consultancy service. For example, give me an example what you're thinking of.
Wala ka eh, kasi magiging an announcement sa networks namin. So,
for example, Dili.
Maybe I'm preempting the second part of your lecture. Because you mentioned a while ago that Vietnam is very active on this.
Mm.
Could you give, let's say, one or two samples
of Vietnamese? Good idea. See, Vietnam, they are very good in workshops and seminars.
Yeah.
Okay? And in that workshop or seminar, meron naka-factor in sometimes, but not all the time, a consultant who will do it for them. So parang turnkey na lang, di ba? We get the project, give it to the consultant, bahala ka na, you just show up. I'm the senior official, I will just make an opening statement. But actually, everything, especially the logistics, the substantive, is taken care of with the consultant. Diba? So that fee, I think, meron ko check na lang kung tawin yung sabi ko. This 20,000, walang below, 19,999, walang pakalam yung APEC doon. Kahit bigay mo kanino, bigay mo sa Vietnamese, bigay niya sa Chinese or whatever. But beyond that, if it's a higher consultancy fee, it has to be bidded out.
So the types of activities are generally workshops and seminars.
Workshops, seminars, symposium, publications, research
publication. Projects. What do you mean by publication?
Books. Pero bihira yun. Kasi APEC, there's a PSU, there's a Policy Support Union. Who does this, who churns out these publications for APEC.
Yung mga consultancy services in terms of research.
Yeah, you can do
commission
that.
Commission research? Or?
Well, commission research would go into the PSU. It doesn't come, it's not coming here. It's an APEC proposal that goes into a separate track, which I don't have an idea of, but I will offer to you as another option.
So research in pursuit of the APEC research agenda.
Yeah, it's the PSU. But, for example, that's why I'm saying you shouldn't just put it sa research lang. Tahin nyo na lang din yung workshop or a symposium or a guidebook. Yes, Jovito. Jovito.
FSI, if I'm not mistaken, I saw one of the projects, no? Sometimes it starts with the workshop.
Yeah.
And then the results,
it would be compiled into a
put in a narrative way, so it becomes a research per se. For example, the workshop is on best practices on sharing economy or whatever,
yeah.
No?
Mm-hmm.
The results of the workshop will be
curated
in a way
that
is presented as a research.
Yeah. Or it could be the other way around. You did the research,
yeah.
Then you want to advocate for it, you do a workshop.
Can chat apply?
Yeah. Anyone can apply. You just have to find a partner agency if you're not attending the regular APEC meetings. But Chet, I think, attends the Human Resource Working Group, di ba? HRD Working Group. So, pwede na kayo dun. Yeah. Are you from Chet? Ah, yun pala eh. Oh, so pwede na kayo. Diretso na kayo, di na kayo dadaan sa ano, sa amin. You just have to work on the collaboration part. And I don't think I've seen a project yet from HRD working group. Yeah. Okay. Good luck. CTI, Committee on Trade, anything trade and investment. Ease of doing business, that would be awesome.
But I mean, on the part of the artisans, are they coming from the private or the state sector?
We had a project na through private sector. The Franchising Association of the Philippines had a project with us. We have them. We're open to working with the private sector, not just government agencies. And we can provide advice. I mean, kahit hindi trade, we'll provide. Yes, ma'am. Ma'am Janet, the expert ka na dyan, may tanong ka pa.
Kasi we had a very good project proposal, I think, 2017.
Mm-hmm.
And it got a very good rating dun sa forum namin, which is the Agricultural Technical Cooperation Working Group. But then, natalo pa rin siya. Saan kaya kami nagkamali?
Okay, alam kung saan. Ano yan? Kasi di ba, yung old na process was it has to be ranked again, di ba? By senior officials. Kasi kayo under senior officials kayo, di ba? Yung AGT, Agricultural Technology and Biotech Working Group, di ba? You are under the SOM Ecotech. Balik natin. Proseso, irarang siya di, irarang siya niyan, and then goes up here, another ranking. All the way, I think it ends there. So, hindi na yan dumaan sa amin, kaya hindi naman siguro ibigay ng ano. Ngayon, kung ASCF, or kunwari, APEC sub-fund, APEC general fund, DFA yung mag-rank. So, you really have to talk to them. Na bigyan kayo ng mataas na ranking. Yeah, oo. So, lahat ito mga ito. Okay, so, talagang, ang mahirap lang, I don't know kung tinututukan natin talaga, yung hindi FSI, talaga di FA ka, dapat talagang matutukan yung, like yung sa ranking. We have to really give preference to our Philippine projects. I think that's number one. Yes, but your project, for example, might fall under some trade stuff. Eh. For example, ano ba? Pwede din yun. Trade yun. Trade in environmental goods yun. That could be CTI, di ba? So, pwede yung pumasok sa TILF, Trade and Investment Liberalization Fund. Yeah. So, yun, papasok yung tamin. Then we will do the ranking.
Meron pa kayong resource na lahat?
Ito yung mga approved lang po, ha? Kapag disapprove, it won't go into that database. But we can give you, alam niyo po, maraming good concept notes eh. But it's more than that. There has to be being able to sell it.
Lobbying question.
Yeah, lobbying.
Kung ba yung ano, kanyara may coffee break sila, tapos nilalapitan ka ng lahat ng
yes. nga talaga that, and it doesn't end there. Like for example, sa HRD working group, we can pull it up all the way to senior officials. Kasi kapag sinabi ni Asik Leo, our senior official na, kinausap niya yung senior official ng China or ng Russia, can you support it? Then they will put their name there.
Kaya kailangan talaga please the personality, no?
Hindi naman din. Pero, you have to extend your, ano, your network. Hindi lang sa fora nyo, bring it up to the senior officials level. Kung pwede nga, the ministerial level. Eh. Si Japan is very good with that. They bring it up to the ministerial level. Na parang, among ministers, nagkakaroon na sila kagad ng agreement. Ah, okay, we support quality infrastructure. Yes, we'll support your guidebook, ganyan-ganyan. And before you know it, we get instructions already from our undersecretaries. Oh, please support the OBS. Pumayag si secretary to support. So, meron yung, there are many ways to scheme a cut. Okay, so, any other, oh, pag wala na question, we'll go to the second part. Was it clear yung sa concept mo? Ideas and priorities. possible projects. Okay. So ito yun, this is the process. The concept note is now approved. It's endorsed with the group, submitted to the secretariat. And then, okay, wait. So now you have a project proposal. This is brought to the group. It has still to be endorsed. Sometimes, yung details talaga itong kapeling mga kamali. And then the secretariat would access the proposal. Ito yung PD, since kanina nakita nyo yung acronym na yung PD, program director, that's the secretariat. She will give you tips and parang, okay, this will not work, so you have to revise. Paulit-ulit lang yan hanggang sa becomes really perfect. And after the revision, eventually you will get yung go ni secretary. Sabi niya, okay nito, this is already acceptable. Then that goes to the PMU na for the final and then the PMC. Okay, this is the link to the project proposal template, the materials, and also the guide. Ito yung show you how it looks. Ito. Well, it's just 3 pages here, but it has to be 12 pages and no more. Tinantay lang. Minsan, pag 13 pages, tas sigurado yan, babalik na talaga kagad sa inyo. You should be able to say it all in 12 pages. Ito yun. So, remember kanina, we talked about relevance, objectives, and alignment. Beyond that, ito yung additional na ilalagay nyo. 12 other items. So, there's the output, the outcomes, the beneficiaries, how you tend to disseminate the learnings or the outputs, gender, so ito parang how does it take in the issue of gender, will there be women in your team, how will it benefit other women in your group or as a whole. So meron kami mga standard na sagot dyan. Work plan, ito yung second Gantt chart pero mas maliit, by month na lang detail. The risk that you expect, for example, you think that there's too little time to invite appropriate guests, you put it there. You think that the speakers, you will not be able to, ano ba yung mga usual na mga risks? Mostly, ano yung preparatory, it's too short. You have to put that also in the proposal. Monitoring and evaluation. Ito kanina, if you remember, I said yung parang if you have baseline data, that would be good to put it. Like, how do you plan to evaluate and improve your knowledge? Kung may baseline data sana kayo, then you can use your post. Linkages, ito, how does it work with yung other fora, other international organizations, that's also good to put. Sustainability, do you plan to have another project after this? If it's a website, for example, who's going to sustain it? You should be able to indicate that also in the proposal. And then, who's the project overseer? This is you. Then you have to describe yourself. Put your short bio in there. And then the budget. So, just quickly lang. We already talked about this kanina. Ayan. But can I just talk about efficiency? Cost efficiency, kasi usually dito na dito sa allow yung mga proposals. Cost efficiency, budget, description of labor, and labor. So, in the guidebook, makikita nyo na rin doon where there are some restrictions. Like for example, honoraria cannot be given to a government official. Okay? It can only be given to the academia, private individuals, or who else? Speakers from international organizations such as UN, WTO, World Health Organization can also not receive honoraria. Okay? But naman, siguro kasi may nakadid sa natin nila. Hindi, kasi parang ano yun? Mahirap. Yeah. So, if they see already, kunwari, in the that's in the implementation stage na. Okay? Warning lang yun. Description of labor, ito. Minsan, they will allow clerical support. So, you sometimes put in that amount in a in their budget. Okay lang yun. Secretariat support, okay lang din yun. But you have to, ano dan, support that talaga with papers, di ba? Paano natin, hindi lang yun pa tayo ganyan, no ba? Wala, no? Secretariat support? Parang wala?
Honorarium
and consultants lang. And the good thing about this, yung APEC, kaya gustong-gusto ko din sa APEC, walang dumadaan ng pera sa amin. So parang, yung travel ng mga participants, we don't even see the money. We just facilitate it. Pero, ano, kumang balance secretariat doon. Which is good kasi it takes a lot of our load, di ba? Hindi ko naiisipin yun, di ba? Yung pag-purchase ng mga tickets and all. No, sila na yun. It's the secretariat who will do that for me. Okay. Then, cost efficiency. For example, they will see, parang masyadong mahal kung binigay yung code, kumpara sa, I think we had that issue with, in our latest project, because we moved from Ascot to Manila Diamond. Basta, we had to justify kung bakit namin gagamitin yung Ascot that time. And the rates were quite higher. Kaya lang, our project overseer was so creative na ano niya. Parang kumain sila, 5-star yung Ascot. Eh. They were able to agree to, pinayagan pa rin kami. So there are some exceptions pa rin. But, yun na nga, huwag nyo na rin pilitin na 5-star kasi that money could still be used, di ba? So, pwede na 4-star. Waivers. Yung waivers, usually this would apply to advanced payments. If you're thinking of putting on a workshop or seminar, your participants would need advanced payments, especially if they're coming from a developing country. Ayaw nila na reimbursement kasi di ba mahirap magpapalabas pa sila ng pera for the hotel. That's too much, even us, di ba? We don't want to do that. We want when we travel, hawak na natin. We already have our allowance and just pay the hotel. You should put an advance waiver for advanced payment in your project proposal. That is in the guidebook. And we always tell our overseers to put that in the concept and in the proposal. That's the only waiver na I think is very important. Okay. Ito, eligibility. Okay, so go back again to the eligibility criteria and the funding priorities. Okay, for this is, well, we just put new relevant subsection. Ito yung sa template na yun. You will see this in the new template. Of course, here the capacity building has to be very, very clear. That will also help you in identifying or coming up with your proposal or your project. Okay. I think it's what we talked about this earlier. Outputs and outcomes, beneficiaries, dissemination. Okay, dissemination. Workshops. So sometimes you come up with a publication after the workshop. But generally now they don't do it on yung hard copies. It's just digital. Okay. So, but still put in an amount in your proposal. Okay, gender. Ito, we talked about this also. Yeah, some recommendations. Not just inviting women. Some practical suggestions are in the guidebook. Tip. Get ideas. By Googling it na lang. Okay, that's so vague. But we will give you parang tips on what to put kasi pare-pareho lang naman eh. Like you could even say very clearly na it's not just because the topic could be beyond gender talaga. It affects anyone. So kung gusto, if you think na ganun yung project, there it's not gender sensitive or it's gender neutral, yeah. Then just go and say it. Oops, no,
okay. Gender can be
We use this in our project on competitiveness in Texas sector. I think they came up, there was a survey survey given out to the participants before they arrived for the workshop. Then we took another survey after the workshop. So yeah, the APEC is very particular about this risk. What could stop you? Some common risk: low interest in participation, or low interest in using the results. Another risk would be duplication of work with other fora or other organizations. You can also put in the risk yung difficulty in achieving policy change. Example, you think that the current administration will not support it, then yeah, sure, again, just put it there. Delays or untimely preparation. These are the more common risks that we put in. On sustainability, ito, do you have to describe the involvement of other fora? How you will engage them? Some examples, will you just simply inviting them in the workshop? Or sharing the results of the project to them? Yan, pwede na yan. Sustainability na yan. Pwede mo na yan. You're already reflecting how other APEC fora will be involved. And always consult with your program director. She might give you some ideas, especially on collaborating, cross-fora collaboration. Tapos in terms of sustainability, also, you could also put here your ideas for follow-up workshops, symposiums or meetings, how you plan to transfer the knowledge to other participants, and including those who were not able to attend the meeting. Ideas also on creating a network, maybe because of something that was said in the workshop, or exchanging of ideas and adopting best practices. Okay, so yeah, those are some of the tips or ideas that you can put to at least satisfy the sustainability part of your proposal. So ito, reporting on progress and composing. So ito, you can skip this. Longer-term evaluation. This is actually a function already of the secretariat. Just this year, I received an email from the secretariat asking about a project I did in 2015. So they do that. So just expect that. There will be a follow-up many years down the road. Ito, budget materials. Ito yung sinasabi ko na parating nakakamali. Yan. Ito, this is the first page, no? And this is the concept note pa lang. When you're developing na your concept note, and you're putting in your idea, your figures here in this part, look at this one. Ito. Ito yung breakdown. So, makikita mo na yan. Gawin nyo na ito na maayos. Kasi dito nyo na makukuha the exact figures. And then, add your contingency.
Yung sub 5
yung counterpart 5. Okay. Sub funding is the government side. Like, for example, you can put a wedding space lang yan, or you can put something here. Because if it's a developing economy making a proposal, there is a requirement that at least 20% of the entire project cost, ito, 20% should come from the us. And should it be very problematic, you just put a figure, for example, on short-term clerical fees, so getting they don't check it anyway, if it's really that fee that you're giving, or just say their fees, or sometimes here, in photocopying, you put the self-funding. There's a portion of the APEC funding, you're also put here. So there are ways to satisfy that 20%. And most of the time, you put it on specialist equipment, like computer.
put an amount back naman. Ang importante is for you to secure yung actual na cost. Yes.
Yung sa ano, project overseer, who determines that? Is it the agency or institution who proposed the concept note, or is it the DTI or the DFA or the concern?
It can be both. It depends with you. If you want only one person, depends also on how engaged your knowledge partner is. For example, PIDS and DFA, diba? You worked on a proposal. If DFA thinks that PIDS will handle the logistics and most of the logistics part, you might as well put them there. If you think you will be handling it, kayo na lang. Because I say na ilagay niyo yung PIDS because they will be sending the reports and they have to sign some of the report. Like they will certify that this particular service, for example, in your project proposal, you put a contractor's consultancy fee of 20,000 or 15,000. Ito. Subconsit to Ateneo, kunwari. If you believe that PIDS will transact on a day-to-day basis with Ateneo, they will do yung certification. Sila na lang ilagay nyo ng project overseer. Lagay nyo na lang din kayo yung name.
So on that part, also, so it doesn't go through the Philippine agency, it goes directly to APEC?
Ano yun? Which one?
Yeah, yeah.
No. That's a hard one. Yeah, it has to be endorsed by the kaya chat, no? HRD working group. That's the first step. Before it even goes to the ranking of the fund that you chose. Okay? Yeah, Human Resource Development Working Group.
Okay. Another question. Regarding sa venue, for example, Philippines yung proposed. Can it be held? Usually, is it held in the Philippines?
Pwede dito, pwede kahit saan.
Depends sa justification.
Yeah, depends. We did a project before, Chemical Dialogue, Board of Investments. We held it in Vietnam.
Was a APEC member company?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
As long as you can assure that it will be, the planning is okay, diba? Parang it's so hard to plan for another place, eh, diba? That means additional cost to you. Because you cannot charge, by the way, you cannot charge your travel to that fund. Ha? That fund for travel, the portion that on travel, is only for the participants and the speakers, not you. Doesn't cover you. Okay? Tandaan niya. I think for research projects, you can do that. In the research project, if, for example, your project covers maybe a compendium of 21 economies, syempre, di ba, that would involve, if you have to interview some economies, that would involve some travel. Probably a large part of your project will go to the travel. Medyo marami na kayo yun. They will question that. Well, PASCN, so that's PIDS, diba? Will first look at kung what agency would be the appropriate home for it. Yeah, cannot go direct. Kasi PASCN does not have, wala silang dalitin eh. They're not a fora that does projects eh.
So on procedure for universities, they write a proposal, submit it to
PASCN studies it, which particular agency can adopt it, then brings it to that agency.
PASCN ba meron silang direct connection to APEC?
pwede din. It has to be based on the topic. Kailangan, kasi kunwari, pwede nga sila, pero paano hindi siya HR related, di ba? It has to be HR related for them to be able to adopt it. Kasi the working group will not be able to endorse it, sabihin it, they will just say, but this is not HR related, why don't you bring it to the economic committee, or why don't you bring it to the subcommittee on customs and procedure?
But these are universities making proposals, eh? Like we work in this also. But if it's economy related, that agenda, how do procedure from the university to the
AI? It has to be through the agency. Sige, Mela. Sagutin mo. Palabas na bas kasi ako, so hindi ko nakita. You mentioned na parang may slide about sino yung mga agencies?
Yeah. Mamaya, we
can do it. Ah, sorry. Okay, so meron nga. So, yun nga, may mga agencies like PIDS is not part of the working, any working group, di ba, present yung mga working group. We only have one, which is the annual study center conference.
Yeah.
So, hindi yun yung mga tipong working group type.
Yeah, so it's endorsed projects.
Usually what we do in the network, let's say there's an invitation coming from the Sedole, and then they will forward, kasi they know PIDS has this network, so they will forward it to us, and then us knowing kung sino yung possible na, let's say they want an expert, share ko lang mo. Let's say the HRD working group or the APEC DSA, they want an expert kasi they want to come up with this competency on the data science analytics. So they send an invitation to the network looking for expert who can participate in that particular conference or workshop. So we circulated it to the network, and then those who express interest, you endorse them. But we're not endorsing by me. So we endorse it to the HRD working group. At that time, it's with only. So, there's a domestic process.
It has to find a fora which can endorse it. And the PA, the APEC Study Center Network does not endorse projects. They will facilitate. But in their meetings, they do not do that. Okay. Just, wrapping up on the budget. Okay. Research cost estimates so that they're realistic, match budget lines to the work plan, ensure calculations are clear, yields and cost, and use the notes section to explain how figures are calculated. Okay. And then again, go back to the guidebook. Kasi ano doon yung mga limits that you can propose in terms of actual figures. Ito yung sinasabi ko about advanced payment and the waiver. Generally, the costs are on a reimbursement basis. For example, you're contracting Dusit Hotel kasi you will hold your seminar there. Hindi pa ring advance. That is always reimbursement. Okay? Except, of course, in the contract it says, di ba, sometimes you have to make a 50% down payment. They will do that. Babayaran yan ng APEC Secretariat. As long as you show it it's in the contract. And then you will make a certification as project overseer that that payment has to be made to X hotel. Okay? They will do that, wala problema. But the remainder, the balance, will have to take to be given after the workshop. Okay? Hindi pwede i-advance na lahat. And then for travel funds, usually it's reimbursement, but as I said, there can be a waiver for advance payments. And this has to be indicated in the proposal. If your project proposal doesn't have this, no way will your participants be able to get advance payment. Okay? So please just put it there. Lagay nyo na lang. And then your contractors, for example, consultancy, like I mentioned, Ateneo, sila yung pinili ng contractor na consultant ng PIDS. The fees will be paid for by the APEC Secretariat directly to the contractor. Hindi na yung dada contract with your knowledge partner says that 10% will be paid upon submission of first draft, 50% remaining 40% on ganito, depending on the agreement or the contract that you have with your consultant. Okay? And you just have to certify as project overseer that this has been completed. For example, that's what we did with ISSI. We just certified that the timelines were followed. Yeah. I think, nabayaran na ba namin kayo, no ba? 100%. Okay, so yun. Madali lang. Di ba? Wala na tayo naging problema. Actually, si late mag-bill sa amin. Eh. Kami excited na kami magbayad, pero sila late pa rin sila mag-bill. Okay. And then, I think, can you share, Nova, kung how to do it? Like, for example, for UP, like, the signatory has to be the chancellor, may mga ganun eh.
Share.
This is important, especially because you might be working on behalf of your universities.
So, in the case of UPISSI, we submitted a proposal on garments, women in garments and textile industry. This was done last April, so it was a workshop. And since the director of our institute is not allowed to sign contracts above 50,000, we have to endorse the contract to the chancellor.
50,000 pesos.
Yes. So that's the CA. So the chancellor signed the contract for us. We submitted it to APEC in Singapore. And then when we downloaded the fund, actually the payment for us is just for the contractor's fee.
Yeah.
And we made use of that amount to cover all the costs that would entail on us. So that we have to submit a line item budget because it has to, the money has to pass through the university, and it would only be transferred to our trust account. So we need to do all the line item budget that would cover all our travel expenses, food, and whatever.
So you did describe, Nova, that is just for the consultancy, because the cost for the workshop that they did was covered by another, by the budget talaga. That was, there was a really budget given for venue, for the travel of the participants and all, okay? And that is because it was ISSI was our knowledge partner. In your case, I don't know how you're going to do it. If you want it to be an individual, you as an individual, that can also be done. We've done that with one of our former directors. She became a consultant of the Department of Energy, and we had a project on trade in energy services. We got her as our consultant. So she was then working. She was an instructor at the UP College of Engineering, but we got her as an individual consultant. So yun, wala na, hindi na kami dumaan sa UP system or all. We went directly to her bank account. So simple lang yun. Very simple. We also do that. In fact, if you have something in mind, you think you can do something, and your university will allow it, why not? Okay lang naman sa amin yun. We're quite flexible. As long as we're able to agree dun sa project, of course. Okay. Okay, ito pala yun. Honoraria, up to 1,500 per event, up to 6 experts per day. Ito yung mga allowable. Translation documents into English, that's also allowed. Contractors. Ito yung sinasabi ko, 20,000 pala, hindi pala 19,990. Okay, so up to 20,000, no need for tendering. 20,000 above, tendering. Okay. Ang mas maganda talaga pag walang tendering. Kasi alam, pwede na namin bilisin mo. Pag may tendering yan, baka may manalo pang iba. Diba? So sorry, iba the project. Kayo yung nanganakip o kayo yung nag-ano. Okay, experts. Ito. Ito something that you just need to know. Yung per diem, 100% of current UN per diem. And they would add, for example, it's a 3-day workshop. It's 3 days at 100% per diem, DSA, plus the 75% of one-off payment. So this would cover yung, if you arrive a day before,
and we'll give a day after, this would cover, kasi ang babayaran mo lang naman is 3 nights, diba, sa hotel, or 3 days. This would cover na rin yung mga terminal fees, yan, ganyan. Transport, yan, that's the 75%. And then airfare, maximum, most direct economical. And they allow business class for 12 hours or more. So for example, you were invited as a speaker in the US, the travel is more than 12 hours, you can claim for business class. Usual expenses per diem, normally as a speaker or expert, 2 travelers from each economy. So there's only ito, something na yun sa baba, that footnote, 11 na travel eligible economies. Kasama tayo dyan. So ito yung mga fina-fund. The rest, they're not funded. It's taken already, you know, take care of their economy. Usual expenses, publication, electronic is recommended. Specialized equipment. Ito, I haven't encountered this. We would put it in our proposal, but we never use this fund. Photocopying communications, never use this fund. Hosting lang madalas, the rental, yun. Yun lang ginagamit namin. Field trips are charged to you. If I will not pay for field trips. Unless that is part of the program or the agenda. Like for example, kinahang makita nyo how they are skinning yung mga mangoes in order for you to understand some of the sanitary and phytosanitary requirements of a particular country. Maybe it could be, but it has to be justified. Okay. Ito yung mga not allowed. So, alin nyo na yan. Internalized. Bawal yung mga promo items. Interpreters. Ayan, yung sinabi ko, honoraria for your government international arts. Ayan. And yun, of course, your travel expenses, they will not pay for it. Meals, coffee, and tea breaks, also not allowed. Pero yun na nga, as I said, there's a way to go around that. Other non-allowed. Conference registration fees, bawal. These are the links that you have to look into. Any questions at this point? So we can, I will go to the more important anana. Okay. Nan, sige, baka na-overwhelm na kayo, sabihin niyo lang. I have more. Ito na. I think ito yung useful talaga. Who are the agencies in charge? I think I already mentioned na kanina. Mentioned na kanina kung sino yung mga important agencies. So, some Ecotech, some senior officials, and some Ecotech is DFA, specifically the Office of International Economic Relations. CTI, that would be us, BITR, Bureau of International Trade Relations. Economic Committee, that's NEDA, with the DTI for the part on ease of doing business and strengthening economic and legal infrastructure, and the Department of Justice for competition policy issues. Industry dialogues. Under the Committee on Trade and Investment, there are 3 industry dialogues: chemical dialogue, automotive dialogue, and life sciences innovation forum. That's under the BOI and the Department of Health. And then the SOM policy partnership. There's a SOM policy partnership on women and economy. So the lead there will be the Philippine Council for Women. Policy partnership on PPSDI, Science and Technology and Innovation, that's DOST. Some policy partnership on food security, that would be DA. And overseeing all of this would be the DFA. And then sector, it's a SEE or the SOM Ecotech, SOM Committee and Ecotech, the Economic and Technical Cooperation. There are many working groups and task forces there. That's the sector agencies and the DFA. So, just going back ulit dun sa ito. Yan, ang dami yan. So, Agricultural Technology Cooperation, DA, Anti-Corruption and Transparency, that will be DOJ, and the Ombudsman, Counter-Terrorism Risk, that would be the National Security Council, Emergency Preparedness, NDRMC, Energy, DOE, Expert Group on Illegal Logging and Associated Trade, that would be DNR and DOC, Health, of course, DOH, HRD Working Group, there's TESDA, there's CHED, and DOE, tatlong agencies yan. And DepEd, sorry. And then Mining Task Force, I think yung Mining Task Force, this will be collapsed, that would be DNR. Oceans and Fisheries, DA, and DNR. Small and Medium Enterprises, that's DTI, specifically the Bureau of Small and Medium Enterprise Development. Telecoms and Information, the ICT, and the NPC. Tourism, Department of Tourism. Transportation, Department of Transportation. Okay, so yun yung mga agencies that you will be working on if you're... So, alam niyo na eh, just from what I'm saying, ang daming pwedeng gawin na projects. Everything. Okay. Ayan, ito pa na. Isa-isa pa. Okay. Anyway, you have a copy of this. Yung sa so I mentioned kanina pala din yung Ecotech. Sa CTI naman pala, we also have a lot of sub-fora under it. So, Automotive Dialogue is Board of Investment. Business Mobility Group, that's DFA, the Office of Consular Affairs. So, ito yung mga tipong those related to migration, those related to yung mga short-term business entry, business visas, yung mga gano'n. Some discussion maybe on, I think, pwede din pumasok dito yung labor mobility, some issues on there. E-commerce steering group, that would be us, DTI, the National Privacy Commission, and the DICT. Group on services is NEDA. Intellectual Property Expert Group is IPO Philippines and National Privacy Commission. I don't know kung bakit NPC. IEG, Investment Experts Group, DOI, Life Science Innovation Forum, DOH, Market Access Group, that's us, BITR, Subcommittee on Customs Procedure, DOC, and Subcommittee on Standards and Conformance, BPSN. So BPS, there's a TWG, there's a technical working group created by the BPS. So we have a representative from the BPS. Maybe Kathy, you can share with us your project during on 2015, remember? Yeah. Member? Okay, sige, share with us how you know that proposal.
Or lower than that, because during that time, the other tayo nga po magpapondo. For instance, hindi tayo ng expert from Chinese Taipei. So sabi nila, oh, kami na magpapondo sa amin. May ganun sila na lang. Meron po silang ganung issue even Australia. Sige, kami na bahala. So yun po yung nangyari that time when we were doing the... Medyo mahirap po at the start kasi we haven't done any APEC project, yung bureau po namin. So medyo talagang kapakapa, pero we were able to pull it through. And then, yun nga po, meron yung indicators sa start ng project. So dapat, medyo po, yung sa dissemination part, medyo may follow through dun sa mga, kunwari, umaten yung mga participant from other economies. Dapat may follow through ako, anong ginawa mo, from the, anong ginawa mo dun sa natutunan mo, yung mga ganun po. So, basically, medyo mahirap, pero it is possible for a first time, ano po, proposer from DPS.
Yeah. Okay, thank you, Cathy. And also, because it was our hosting year, so sunod-sunod, sabay-sabay pa yung trabaho nila. They were chairing the meeting, they were hosting this workshop and all. But it was very successful because it was reported also in, I think it was reflected in the statement, and we were uploaded by a number of economies. And for the cross-fora collaboration, the results were also shared with the economic committee. So yeah, that was a good experience for us, especially for DPS. Okay. Economic committee, the other important committee, ito yun, I mentioned earlier, competition policy, you need to talk to the Philippine Competition Commission. Ease of doing business, that's DDI. Regulatory reform, that would be NEDA. Public sector governance, also NEDA. And CELI or Strengthening Economic Legal Infrastructure, that would be NEDA. And also maybe DDI, depends on what particular area it could fall under. Okay, so yun. Ang tip ko lang, focus on an area where the project can add value. Yun lang. Ganun kasi. And then if you're still on the early stage, drawing, I mean, just still coming up with the concept, look at the sources, the leader's statement, leader's declaration, the ministerial statement. Although nga ngayon, kasi wala pa rin kami statement dahil hindi sila nakapag-produce from Port Moresby, hindi ko nga alam kung ano gagamitin namin for next year. Okay. But you can draw from the previous statements, 2017. Then, unexplored work or gaps, baka meron hindi pa nagagawa masyado. Initiatives of other international organizations that you think APEC could do also that has not been done yet. Then from domestic constituencies, for example, in your university, baka big issue ngayon na waste. Well, maybe you can start something on that. And then consult. This more for us, siguro na in the government. How to, we need to reach out to other economies. We might have the same ideas, and we could just work on one particular project instead of us competing with each other. Then sometimes a program director would have ideas also. Again, domestic constituencies, and then committee and foreign representatives. So siguro kami, minsan we have a lot of ideas in my team alone, sa APEC section namin. Pero parang we don't have really time to do it. So although I have a, meron akong targets sa kanila. Parang every year we should have a project. So last year we had one, the year before I think we had. So, oh, by the way, we had a project pala na ano, it was a publication. Kaya lang, instead of us proposing it as a project, inano na lang namin, pinasa namin sa policy support unit. That's like the research arm of APEC. So sila na yung naganap ng, ano, ng expert for us, ng consultants. Okay. Ito, some tips. Always inform the fora of your project concept. No. You're not alone. And you're not an island. Use the TIPA meetings, technical board on APEC matter meetings to socialize your ideas and proposals. If you cannot attend our TIPA meetings, course it through your PIDS. They're your PASCND. And
During project implementation, provide regular updates to FORA lead on project implementation to ensure attendance or awareness. Okay, send ng ganda-ganda ng proposal mo, approve and all, implementation. Sampung taon na dumating. Why? Because they know na dito na pala yun yung host and that this time. Yan. So yan, it's just really communication. Hindi na sabi. So what's, ito pa, some ideas for, and I'm giving this to you kasi ito yung mga priority areas ngayon ng APEC. RTAs, that's regional trade agreements, free trade agreements, and the free trade area of the Asia Pacific. Trade facilitation, that's big, always big in APEC. That's one of their core business. Services trade, digital economy. I thought this is gonna be very important kasi Chile, who's the next host, this is one of their priorities. MISMIS. It's very close to everyone's heart. I think walang bansa nagsabi na they don't like their business. Regulatory cooperation and coherence. Agriculture, well, ito, dagdag ko na to. I want to do something on agriculture, subsidies, and NPMs. Investment facilitation, I also want that. Circular economy, I like this also. I think this is going to be big. Inclusive trade, that's very broad, but these are, well, this is, has been the ano, parang, the advocacy of the Philippines in APEC, inclusive globalization, inclusive trade, and green supply chains. I also love, I think this is also very useful. Okay. So it just goes beyond trade, some of this. Economic committee, some ideas, yeah. Actually, I just put the names of the friends of the chair under the economic committee in the topic. Online dispute resolution, that's a new thing in APEC. I think maganda yung, if we could do something on this. Kung may experts sa inyo dyan. Regulatory impact analysis also, baka some case studies hasn't been done. Ease of doing business, quite a lot has been done. Tsaka ito, pero madami kasi diba yun, if you're familiar with the World Bank ease of doing business report, maraming factors under that eh. So, pwedeng isa-isahin natin. Pwedeng trading across borders, contracts, pwedeng maraming ano pa yun. So, you can pick a lot of ideas from there. And then, for the SOMECOTEC, ito. Those are the things. Okay. So, anything, actually, anything under the sun that's related to the economy or the trade or the investment, you can come up with a concept note. Okay. Process for approval. Ito, how do we do it then? Pag, on parang more practical or in a real life situation. Well, first you do your consultations. You have ideas already. Identify an initiative that needs funding. Then come up with the concept note, first draft, identify your co-sponsors. If you do not have an idea kung sino pwedeng co-sponsor nyo, talk to the agency, your partner agency. They will give you ideas and they will help you look for your co-sponsor. Then your partner agency will also link you up with your program director, or they can do it themselves so you can find co-sponsors. Second draft of your, when you're all set with your concept note, this will now be presented and circulated at the fora. For example, the Mining Task Force or the Energy Working Group. And then it will require endorsement. Hopefully it will be re-endorsed and then it will be ranked according to the self-fund using the APEC scoring template results. Sometimes though it's not endorsed by the fora, okay lang, sige, balik natin ulit. Hanggang sa ma-endorse siya. Then, minsan, maganda talaga very early to look to already seek for endorsement. Para, if it's not endorsed, you still have time to revamp your concept note until you get that endorsement. Although, you're still working within a specific timeline kasi nga dalawa lang yung session, submission, project session submission. Project submission sessions. If you
visit in the first, then you go for the second. Okay. So already you submitted your concept note, it got approved for funding. Congratulations, you go to the full proposal preparation. Hopefully your proposal is approved. It's not approved for funding, okay, you think of self-funding. Sorry. So yun, balik kayo ulit, so pinakita ko. Basically, it's still the same format. Pareho pa rin yung sa concept note, diba? It still has to be endorsed. And the other option would be ito, si scenario B. Scenario B, you always have that, especially when you're a negotiator, dapat panati kami scenario B. Scenario B would be the policy support unit. Okay. Meron ka talagang idea for research that you think will help the world. Solve protectionism. It's so keen on it talaga. You go to the policy support unit. Yung lang, the limitation, those that go to the policy support unit are mostly commissioned researchers. Okay? They're the terms of reference are determined by the proposing economy or fora. And you have to compete with other research organizations because normally the budget is really big. But there's a way towards it. You can ask the economy. You can ask your partner agency to raise it as a proposal. Ito, we haven't done it yet. Hindi pa namin ito nagawa. But we want to explore this track wherein we can talk to the policy support unit and present our research institutions as viable or possible consultants. Hindi pa natin, ito yung mga gusto kong gawin, di ba, Mark? Talagang kailangan ma-present natin yung mga universities natin. So we are still exploring this, but we can, I think it's really just a matter of telling the PSU people na we have universities in the Philippines who can do some of the studies. And to go around yung sa commissioning, kasi commission siya, so hindi kayo naka-determine. You need to work closely with us para alam namin kung ano yung particular project na yun. Although, we cannot guarantee you if the terms of reference or that proposal is approved as a PSU study, that contract will go to you. Hindi kami sure about that. Hindi namin, kasi you have to compete with the others. But we want to make steps to be able to present our Philippine universities as possible consultants. Okay. And we should have an inside track on that because one of the ideas, alumni ba si Dr. Basadilla? Yeah, she came from the PSU, so she should be able to help us get into the PSU system. Okay. So next time, Labat, siguro you have to talk to her. So how we can get contracts for our research. Pero yun nga, as I said, commission to. Kunwari, it's not you. It's hindi natin naisip to between us, the Philippine government, might be another economy suggesting it, proposing this particular study. But I think the experience will be very useful for our universities. Okay, so yeah, that's it. And if you have questions, suggestions, or ideas, please feel free to email them. And we'll help you, whether it's CTI issue. If it's not, then we will direct you to the proper agency and also give you some of the tips. Okay, so with that.